am Michael Polozola with the LSU Ag Center, and now we're going into year three of our strawberry trial here in the central region. We've had some exciting results and found some varieties that have done really well, and we've had some varieties that have disappointed us that we've rotated out. And as we've rotated varieties out, I'm trying to always incorporate new varieties in to see how they hold up compared to what's done well so far, and whether or not I need to update and say this one actually performs much better than another. Right now I'm sitting in front of one called Camino Real, and so far it's done excellent for me as an annual, and I would recommend it great for anyone who wants to start. Now I haven't seen how it's going to do in the summer heat, because here we are at right at the beginning of May looking at them, and strawberries are going to be probably at their peak right now. But I want to run them through a summer so we can see. But so far I've had a lot of promising traits with this. I've been real pleased with the fruit I've gotten, been sweet, very nice sized. The plants have been vigorous, but we'll carry it through a summer and you can see whether or not in year four update it's still recommended. Now we're going to go and look at some others that have still performed well for us and give you a little synopsis on what I found, how they do, and they've been doing well. So we're going to revisit one of my favorites from previous years called Mara debois. It is a French selection, and it has proven to be very disease tolerant and very heat tolerant. Fairly fruitful, but excellent flavor. Now it is still susceptible to a leaf spot every now and then, and if it's just happening on a handful of leaves, you can prune those out. Later in the season, it may get more of an issue. It tends to happen more when you do overhead watering, so you may want to make certain that you're watering just the substrate or soil as opposed to getting water on the leaves. Now the flavor is excellent. Now that does come with a little bit of post-harvest trade-off. It gets very soft, so you're going to want to harvest it fairly early. It does make a little bit smaller fruit because of its cross with a more wild parentage, but if you fertilize heavily, you can get nice sized fruit like this. This is what I would call medium to large size. This would be a little bit more of your average if you're fertilizing very lightly, but excellent flavor once you let it develop all the way. Taste exactly what you would dream a strawberry should taste like. One of my favorite ones to grow. Definitely a worthwhile inclusion in your garden. So this is a variety that has performed extremely well for me, one called Eclair. And it has had very good heat tolerance, very good vigor, and look at the size. This is about an average sized one for me. They have a tendency to even get larger than this, especially if you fertilize them heavily, but they tend to be very vigorous. Some of them didn't respond as well to summer pruning, so you're going to want to prune it kind of moderately, but it does need a little bit of cutback because it does grow so thick later in the season. But it also produces plenty of runners, so if you do lose some, you can fill in those spots. Been extremely pleased with the flavor of it too, because often with a large berry you lose some of your flavor. But this one has done really well. You're going to want to let it ripen a good bit of the way. Remember, strawberries do not ripen after you harvest them, although they may taste a bit sweeter after being chilled. So you're going to want to leave them out here, get a nice size before you harvest it. But Eclair is one I've been very pleased with. Very vigorous plant growing. Gets into production earlier in our season when we can take advantage of the cooler weather. And it will tolerate the heat of the summer and come back fairly well, propagating from runners. So this is Seascape. We've talked about this variety. It's been in my trial since the very beginning. And one of the reasons it was is because it's very easily accessible. You can get it from multiple sources fairly easy. It's not one of my favorite ones, but I like to keep watching it because people can get it. And it has decent heat tolerance and fair disease resistance. Berries, this is about average size. Can be a bit on the tart side. You're going to definitely want to let them ripen. There's some varieties that I think are superior to it, but I know a lot of people, this is what they're going to be able to get at their gardening centers. So I'd like to just keep watching it. It's worthwhile inclusion if it's the only thing you can get. It does not respond well to summer pruning, something I discovered last year, but it is does make runners, and we will fill in these spots that are missing. It's kind of our average run-of-the-mill variety, and it's okay to grow it if that's what you have access to. So now let's revisit one that I spoke real highly of in the past two seasons, one called Purple Wonder. Excellent flavor. Only caveats I have with it is it's very expensive because it's still a patented variety. And I'm finding variable rates of how it likes to grow. So I really prefer growing my strawberries in a tower. It's much easier for me to manage a bunch of varieties this way. But Purple Wonder's actually not enjoying being in the tower quite as much as it is in a potted setting like this. Now that may actually be better, because if you're looking to get an establishment of Purple Wonder, it's going to be much cheaper to maybe get two plants and let them grow and fill out. They do have a very crowning habitat, and I'm still going to attempt in this, and I may just have to use these to propagate plants to put here. But as far as a homeowner, I would only get one or two plants, see how it grows in your location to whether or not it's worth it for you to commit. And you may find that even though it tastes a little bit better than some of the others, Mara's an excellent selection, much easier to grow, may just be more worth it to look into other varieties. But I'm still gonna keep looking at it just because I really like the dark coloration it can get later in the season, and it has a strong flavor profile. But it's one of those on the fence, and going forward, it's always gonna be a marginal recommendation anyway because of cost of installation, and it may just have a few other demerits later on. But it's a great novelty plant, and if you want a talking point, one that makes a very darkish purplish berry late in the season, worth having just one or two plants. So here's a variety I want to highlight that I'm looking at, one called Charlotte. What I really like about it is Mara's one of the parents of it, so it has a great flavor profile. Preliminary, I got just a few plants in late last season, so I couldn't give a recommendation, but they have done well. They survived over the summer, ordered a few more plants to fill in, and I've been really pleased with it so far. We'll try to check in with it next year and see if I'm still pleased with it, but excellent fruit, bigger than Mara, similar flavor profile. Does have a tendency to get a little leaf spot, but fine otherwise. So I want to give an update on Albion here. Albion's an interesting one, has a very much cone-shaped fruit compared to a lot of the others, very distinctive in that. When it ripens all the way, it is very sweet. Often you're going to have to harvest it before it ripens at the top because they will start to go bad at the bottom. It's really on the marginal list for me. Heat tolerance is kind of middling, and disease tolerance is becoming kind of middling as well. But it does perform decently. As I've told other people, it's one that's always on the chopping block for me, but there's always something that keeps it from being thrown out. So that does mean I hope to find ones that are more vigorous to eventually show, but if you only have access to Albion, it's still a decent selection, still should perform well, just not as strong as, say, like the Eclair in plant vigor and coming back year to year.